First phase of elections today, 102 seats in the 21 states. It's the biggest phase of the election 2024, but the focus is going to be mainly on Tamil Nadu today, where all 39 Lok Sabha seats are going to vote. Like I said, Veera Raghav joins us live from Chennai. Harsha is also with us. But Veera, to you first, all eyes, like I said, are going to be on the state of Tamil Nadu today. What's at stake? Break it down for us.
Well, yes, Rishika, all eyes on Tamil Nadu, but for the moment, all eyes at the Stella Maris polling booth here. You know who we're waiting for? We're waiting for the one and only Rajnikanth to come and vote. Because when you start your day with Rajnikanth, you can expect to have a super hit show for the rest of the day. So we're expecting him to come down here in the next half hour to cast his vote like he has always done. Obviously, you've got some of the first few voters, early morning Chennai voters. You see the man there? He's already cast his vote there, showing an inspirational message to all the youngsters and all the South Chennai youngsters. Let me just get him, sir. We're from NDTV.
Yes.
You know, is there a message to youngsters to come out and vote like you early in the morning?
Of course, yes, because it's a fundamental right. We need to do it for the development of the country.
You're one of the first voters to come in here.
Yeah, because I live close by. I go for a walk in the morning, so after the walk, I just come in, finish
nice.
And go.
Thanks very much. So you see, the early morning voters already up here at Stella Maris College casting their first votes. Remember, it gets very hot in about a couple of hours from now. And Chennai usually sees a brisk uptake in votes between 7 and 9 or 7 and 10. You get all the politicians, all the big shots, all of them coming in to vote. This is a historic polling booth, actually, Rishika. There was a time when Jayalalitha used to come and vote here. Rajnikanth has always voted here. This is just next to Spoils Gardens, where side of this road is where M. Karunanidhi used to live. So a lot of us journalists have jumped between this polling booth and the one which is very close by to get the top political shots of Tamil Nadu. We'll get you all the latest that's coming out of here, all the big faces coming in to cast their vote. So for the moment, no predictions, no political analysis. Let's keep it focused only on the voters and the big faces coming in to vote. And the only message out there, like everywhere else, Chennai South, all the urban apathy, people need to shed those. Don't go away for a long weekend. If you're planning to go away, get down here, vote, and then go away. That's really the message at the moment, Rishika. As you said, 39 parliamentary constituencies going into the polls, along with the one in Puducherry, all in one shot. A crucial state, given the kind of national focus that's been there. DMK on the one side, you've got the AIADMK on the other side, the traditional allies, and of course the BJP trying to make an entry into Dravidian heartland.
Well, absolutely, Veera. And the focus today is not on the candidates, but on the voters. I think that's the note to have, a good note rather, to have begun this day on, because now the proverbial red carpet, like we say, has been laid out. And it is today that the voter is king. We'll try and get you maximum voices from across the length and breadth of India. It is the biggest phase. Yes, the red carpet there right behind you. Absolutely. So not a proverbial red carpet, a literal red carpet there behind you. But do stay on with us. Sam's
carpet.
Also joining us now. And Sam, we'll come to you in just a moment. But Harsha, you know, to you now, you're in Jaipur. Rajasthan, of course, is a key state to watch out for. The BJP is eyeing a hat-trick performance, so to speak, there. But 12 seats out of 25 will, in fact, go to the polls today.
Yes, 12 seats out of 25 are going to the polls. And in fact, these seats are also seeing some key contests. You know, there is Nagaur, where there's a tough fight between the lady who's joined, who was from the Congress family, Nathuram Mirdha's family. Jyoti Mirdha goes into the BJP. She lost the MLA elections, but she's again fighting as MP. You have Devendra Jhajaria, who's taking on Rahul Kaswaha, who's also left the BJP and gone to the Congress. So there's a fight for a very key caste vote, which is the Jats. And of course, like you were saying, the BJP is hoping for a hat trick. But before I go to that, let me just speak to this young man who's come in. Morning walk pe gaye the aap shayad, aur pehla vote, he's cast the first vote, and his little daughter's come also. And of course, she's not a voter, but I think she's got her finger inked. So let me start with her. You're not a voter, but aapne ink lagwaya hai. To aapko kya message hai voters ke liye?
कि आज किसी को भी जो 18 years से above हैं, उनको आज घर पे नहीं बैठना चाहिए और उनको भी आके वोट डालने चाहिए.
So are you waiting to become 18?
Yes.
How much time to go before you become 18?
I am 10 years old.
Oh, so she's still got 8 years to vote, but she's given an important message. Thank you so much. आपने पहला वोट डाला क्या आज?
हाँ, आज पहला वोट डाला और बहुत प्राउड फील होता है. इसने मेरे को, बेटी ने मोटिवेट किया कि अपने को सबसे पहला वोट डालना है. तो आज हम जल्दी उठे, जल्दी नहाए और जल्दी वोट डालने आए.
ओके, ग्रेट. सो आई एम सीइंग सर, लॉट ऑफ द ओल्डर पीपल आर आउट फॉर मॉर्निंग वॉक्स एंड दे आर वोटिंग. ऑफ कोर्स दिस यंग पर्सन हियर,
बट मैं सुबह 6 बजे निकला था. और अभी तो व्यवस्था की बात करूंगा, क्योंकि व्यवस्था बिल्कुल भी नहीं है, ना तो पर्चियों की, ना बड़ी मुश्किल से तो मेरे को पर्ची मिली यहाँ से.
ओके ओके,
खैर ठीक है, बहुत बढ़िया. Thank you very much.
So all the older people are out more than younger people.
Right? Yes, no doubt.
All early
older
risers.
Older are rather more vigilant about their votes.
Okay. So all early risers, as you can see. But like we were talking about Rajasthan, you know, the 12 seats that go to the polls, very interesting fights there, like we were saying. And Dausa is another key contest. I forgot to mention that. Dausa is another key contest. In fact, it's the seats of North Rajasthan and East Rajasthan that are voting. Dausa, key contest, again, a fight there for the BJP. So, you know, the Congress is actually putting up a good show in this election. Of course, we're not going to get into any poll predictions, but Arjun Ram Meghwal from Bikaner defending his seat. There's also Bhupendra Yadav, entering grassroots politics for the first time from Alwar. So all in all, the 12 seats of Rajasthan that are going to vote in the first phase are quite interesting, and they're seeing some key contests.
All right. Well, it's going to be very interesting to see how the battle for Rajasthan plays out, because, you know, the BJP is eyeing a hat trick. 25 out of 25. Can they max it out this time around is going to be the big question. But very interesting to see, Harsha, the cross section of people who've come out this morning, mostly early risers, morning workers coming to cast their ballot. And of course, that young girl, I think we'll try and play out that that little bit of that interview with a 10-year-old who's got her finger inked, even though she can't vote. She has 8 more years to go, but she sent out a crucial message to those of you who are still wondering whether you should step out and vote. If you're watching this, well, you most definitely should. So we'll now go back to Sam joining us from Chennai. We have Saurabh Gupta also, who's joining us live from West Bengal, 3 seats in Bengal, also seeing the polls today. We'll go back to Saurabh in a bit. But Sam, back to you. It's a very interesting contest in Tamil Nadu this time around. There's a lot at stake, a four-cornered contest. The BJP and the AIADMK, of course, have split ways, contesting against each other in this election. It's going to be really interesting to see how this four-cornered contest plays out. It's going to be advantage who, but today is not about the politics. Today, it is about the voter and the interest and issues of the voter. What is top of mind for people as they come out to vote in Tamil Nadu today?
Rishika, to begin with, we come to you from South Chennai constituency at SIET College. This is the polling station where Chief Minister M.K. Stalin and his family would come and cast their vote around 8:30. Voters are slowly trickling in, and this is a kind of a prestige seat for all the political parties, South Chennai, because this includes the IT corridor, the commercial hub of T-Nagar, the film industry hub of Vadapalani, 6 assembly constituencies, and traditionally this has been a DMK bastion. But for voters in Chennai, this is the area which was worst affected during the 2023 floods, actually. So that will be one key aspect in their mind as they decide to vote for whichever party they decide, whichever party. And it's a four-cornered contest technically, but the key fight could be between the DMK, the AIADMK, and the BJP. In terms of the candidates, of course, the DMK's Tamilachi is trying for a second term. The AIADMK has fielded former MP Dr. Jayavardhan, and the BJP has fielded former Governor Tamilasai, who has now decided to make a political plunge and to make a splash in politics. So that's the big question. Will the DMK be able to continue with sweep it had in 2019? Will the AIADMK be able to regain or reclaim its lost ground? Or will the BJP be able to break new grounds in this Dravidian heartland, expand their footprint, or win possibly some seats? That's a big question. All answers would be on the month of June.
Yes. Well, Sam, you know, I want to just, before we go back to Harsha, I want to very briefly just talk about, since we're talking about the issues of the people, I think there have been some very distinctive issues that have been raised as far as the political parties are concerned in Tamil Nadu. If you look at the way the BJP has upped the ante against the opposition over the Kachathivu Islands, or whether you look at the way the entire Sanatan Dharma controversy has played out, that remark, it remains to be seen whether this really has any resonance on the ground in Tamil Nadu. It may have seen resonance in other parts of the country. It may have seen some resonance in, say, the Hindi heartland, for instance, at least as far as the Sanatan Dharma controversy or that comment is concerned. But does this really have resonance with the people of Tamil Nadu? Are these issues that people of Tamil Nadu are voting on, or like you said, you know, are they going to be more fundamental existential issues like flood relief?
Well, for political parties, it's a different issue altogether, besides the issues of price rise, corruption, unemployment and things like that. The ruling DMK has taken up the issue of federalism, issue of states' rights, and how the central government, in its view, is denying additional special packages to help in restoration and rebuilding of flood-ravaged areas, including Chennai and southern districts. For the DMK, the question of Sanatan Dharma traditionally has been paying them rich dividends, because unlike the Hindi heartland, Sanatan Dharma is being seen through the prism of caste discrimination in Tamil Nadu. So it's not, that comment is not being seen as something against Hindu religion or as an attack on Hindu religion largely, but as an attack on the traditional age-old practice of caste discrimination, which Dravidian parties have been fighting for. So in that sense, it may not work against the DMK largely. Of course, there are still a small percentage of people who look at that as an attack on Hindu religion. But largely, if you look at the history, this issue helps the DMK to actually win votes. This time, we should wait and we see how it will help or it will work against the party in the ongoing elections now. The AIADMK has taken up the issue of, again, rights of states. It feels that there is anti-incumbency in Tamil Nadu, and that will help the party to reclaim its lost ground. This is the first election for the AIADMK chief EPS under his singular leadership in that sense. So it's also kind of an acid test for his leadership after suffering two consecutive losses in elections it fought in alliance with the BJP. Lastly, the BJP, of course, has taken up the issue of corruption and family politics against the ruling DMK and also against its former ally, the AIADMK. It doesn't have a major ally in Tamil Nadu this time, but it's hoping that whatever the Prime Minister has been campaigning here will help. And it has taken up the issue of family politics and also focusing on the issue of Kachathivu, for instance, the island which was ceded to Sri Lanka in the year 1974.
That was my question, right? Have the issues that have been raised by the political parties, for instance, are they in sync with the real issues of the people? I think that is what is going to be really key to see, because like I said, the campaign pitch has been very high as far as Tamil Nadu is concerned this time around. There's been a very high octane campaign for Tamil Nadu. We'll come back to you, Sam, in just a moment. I also want to go across to Saurabh Gupta joining us from Cooch Behar. Saurabh, three seats in Bengal today. So not a very big phase as far as Bengal is concerned, but you're in Cooch Behar, which is one of the key constituencies to watch out for. Break it down for us. What's happening there?
Three seats in West Bengal go to polls today. Cooch Behar, Alipurduar and Jalpaiguri. Now, all three seats have their unique issues. But at this point, we are at the booth where Nishit Pramanik, the Union MOS home, will vote. And you can see people have already lined up to vote. आप लोग यहाँ पे सुबह सुबह वोट देने आए, सुबह सुबह कैसे आ गए?
सुबह सुबह इसलिए क्योंकि मुझे काम पे जाना होगा, इसलिए मैं सुबह सुबह आया।
मतलब आप वोट देके काम पे जाओ?
हाँ।
That's an important message, you know, people who have to get to work early are coming here to vote. आप भी काम पे जाओगे वोट देके?
हाँ।
और वोट देने के लिए यहाँ पहुँचना एक बहुत बड़ी बात होती है, सबकी जिम्मेदारी होती है। आप लोग सुबह सुबह वो जिम्मेदारी निभा रहे हो? यहाँ पे कितने बजे से लाइन में हैं?
सात बजे से।
तो वोटिंग शुरू हो गया?
हो गया अभी।
ठीक है। So a lot of people coming in to vote, and of course, you know, I can show you the ladies' line also on the other side of the polling booth. And all polling booths, I must say, are being manned by central security forces. Cooch Behar, remember, is a border district, and therefore you will see a lot of security here, a lot of security in terms of central forces. This is the place where the BJP has fielded its heavyweight candidate, Nishit Pramanik, who was the former MOS home. Of course, now elections are there. And of course, he was someone who served as Amit Shah's deputy in the union government. So a very important candidate in that context. Then you also have Jalpaiguri, where recently there was a storm that has become a political issue.
Yes.
You know, both the BJP and the TMC have campaigned on it. And you also have Alipurduar, where the BJP has had to change its candidate, but has fielded a very strong local leader, Manoj Tigga. Not Bengal. All these three seats were with the BJP, and the BJP is hoping to keep its bastion safe while the TMC is trying to regain lost ground in this area.
Yes, Saurabh, we're going to come back to you in just a moment and, you know, talk a little more about the larger picture that is emerging in Bengal. But I want to quickly crisscross across from West Bengal all the way to Rajasthan, where we have Vedant joining us live from Alwar. Vedant, Alwar is going to be one of those seats that's going to be very keenly watched on counting day, because you have a political heavyweight of the BJP who's actually making an electoral foray in a certain sense, because he's never really contested an election from the ground. Bhupinder Yadav contesting there, and the Congress has put up a young face against him. So a lot at stake in Alwar in terms of both the actual battle for Alwar and the perception battle for the BJP.
That's right, Rishika. It's been a heavy, a high voltage campaign here in Alwar. In fact, we were on the campaign trail with Bhupinder Yadav. He exuded a lot of confidence, but it's his poll debut. It's a neck and neck fight here. But let's get in a sense from some voters here. Long queues already. It's a hot morning here in Alwar. Let's try and get in a sense from some early morning voters here. Sir, apna naam bataiye.
Raj Bahadur Jagir.
यहाँ पर आज अलवर का वोटर किन मुद्दों पर वोट कर रहा है? पानी का बहुत बड़ा मुद्दा है ऐसा मुझे
तीन से तीन चार समस्या है. पूरे शहर में पानी की सबसे बड़ी समस्या है. हर महिला परेशान है, हर परिवार परेशान है, लेकिन पर कोई राजनीतिक दल इस पे ध्यान नहीं दे रहा है. केवल वोट लेने आते हैं, न पानी की समस्या को दूर करते हैं, ना यहाँ कोई साफ सफाई करते हैं
जी. और एक बात ये बताइए कि बहुत लोगों को लगता है कि ये गाँव की समस्या नहीं है, अलवर शहर में मैंने पिछले दो तीन दिन में देखा ये पानी की समस्या शहर की समस्या है यहाँ पर.
यस, ये जरूरी है. ये तो पानी तो सबसे ज़्यादा जरूरी है. अलवर में सबसे बड़ी समस्या पानी की ही बनी हुई है
जी. राजस्थान की महिलाओं, पिछले कुछ सालों में हमने देखा है महिलाएं बहुत भारी तादाद में आकर वोट करती हैं. राजस्थान की महिला आज किन मुद्दों पर वोट कर रही है?
पानी के लिए ज़्यादा कर रही है सबसे ज़्यादा. भी पानी होगा, पानी तो है ही नहीं रहा. पानी की समस्या से दूर करो पहले
जी. All right, let's quickly get in a word from some voters who have already cast their votes as well. Aap log ne apna vote dal diya, apna vote dikha dijiye sabse pehle. So these are some of the early morning voters here. Aap bataiye kya mudde hain yahan par aaj jab Rajasthan ka voter vote karne ja raha hai. Abhi state assembly elections bhi yahan par hue the. Yahan par aap jo hai national issues par vote karte hain ya phir yahan ke jo local mudde hain un par vote karte hain?
Sabse bada mudda aaj ki tareekh mein Sanatan ka hai.
अच्छा,
यदि वोट नहीं किया गया तो ये सनातन धर्म खत्म हो जाएगा.
आप बताइए यहाँ की महिलाओं के दिमाग में क्या चल रहा है, क्या सोचकर वोट किया आज?
सोचे भी पानी की समस्या भी थोड़ा दूर होगी
जी,
धीरे धीरे.
वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग. वी हैव अ कपल हियर, यू नो, सर वोटेड ऑन यू नो नेशनल इशूज लाइक सनातन धर्म एटसेट्रा ऑफ कोर्स विच हैज बीन द सेंट्रल थीम ऑफ द बीजेपी. एंड मैम हियर हु कास्ट अ वोट, शी सेड दैट इट्स द लोकल इशूज दैट मैटर, इंक्लूडिंग द वाटर इशू, द वाटर क्राइसिस हियर इन अलवर. इट्स गोइंग टू बी अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट बैटल फॉर द बीजेपी. द बीजेपी हैज फील्डेड इट्स बैकरूम स्ट्रेटेजिस्ट, इट्स क्राइसिस मैनेजर इन भूपेंद्र यादव, एंड ऑफकोर्स द कांग्रेस गिविंग अ वेरी टफ फाइट. In fact, the Congress won 5 out of the 8 seats here in Alwar in the assembly polls.
Yes.
It's going to be an interesting battle to watch out for, Rishika.
Well, thanks, Vedant, for getting us a sense of what's really happening on the ground. And very interesting, Veera, I want to come back to you here because, you know, just a moment ago, Sam and I were talking about exactly the same thing. Issues like Kacha Tivu, issues like Sanatan, and I just asked him the same question that, you know, Sanatan may have resonance in the Hindi heartland, but does it really have resonance in Tamil Nadu? I think has this entire controversy really become a poll issue? And we just had a voter, interestingly, in Alwar talking about Sanatan, but we don't have too many in Tamil Nadu talking about Sanatan.
Well, that's right, Rishika. I do, though, feel that it's unfair to pick up these campaign issues on the morning of voting and you know, sort of high project them, because this was a high-voltage campaign.
Yes.
And I think for the moment, the focus has to be more on voting, whatever. But, you know, ultimately, yes, these were issues. There was an ideological confrontation line that was pushed by the DMK. That was their campaign. The BJP had focused on family rule and corruption. The AIADMK had focused on local anti-incumbency. So several factors, whether they worked or not, we'll know on the 4th of June. And once Tamil Nadu votes, we've had enough time to discuss it. But as I told you, what we're waiting for, who are we waiting for? We're waiting for Rajnikanth here in Stella Maris. He may be politically irrelevant, but entertainer-wise, he's always got the eyeballs. If you can just turn around here, you see the entire media is waiting here for him to come and then cast his vote out here, inside here at the Stella Maris voting booth. You don't know when he's going to come, as always. Only when he comes will you know that he's arrived. So that's pretty much the way it is. Look, there's a huge crowd of people running in. Oh, that's Anirudh. That's the music director, Anirudh, going in to vote. We'll try and get him in a bit. So you've got a lot of high-profile star personalities coming in to vote here at the Stella Maris voting booth. We'll get you that. But yes, going back to the question that you were asking, Rishika, in terms of the larger picture, remember, 39 plus 1, 40 seats up for the grabs here in Tamil Nadu, and it's always been a swing state. And I think the contest here this time has been that there's been this ideological battle that you've spoken about at one level, BJP versus DMK, but on the grassroots there's also a DMK versus AIADMK battle. How this pans out, how the vote shares pan out, would be fascinating to understand post-polls and perhaps form the benchmark for how Dravidian politics play out.
Yes, and I think, Veera, you know, the larger question on issues stemmed from what is on the voters' mind as they go to vote. Because, you know, like you said at the very beginning of this broadcast at 7 a.m., that today is not about the netas, it's not about the parties, but it is about the voters and it is about what's on their mind as they go ahead and vote. And most importantly, I think very interesting because so many celebrities and, you know, Rajnikanth expected where Veera is. All of this is very important, sends out a message, perhaps encourages more people to vote. You know, if you go out early and you're casting your vote at Stella Maris where Veera is, who knows, you may bump into Rajnikanth. So, you know, go out and go out early and vote before the temperatures.
Well, that's good motivation there, Rishika.
Yes. That's good motivation
like to get the youngsters to come out and vote. You want to see Rajnikanth, come down here, vote.
We do our bit. We'll do our bit, Veera. We'll continue to do our bit. But no, I think urban apathy is one of those issues that you raked up in the morning, and I think that's very, very important, especially where you are in Chennai. We saw long queues where Vedant is in Alwar. We haven't seen any long queues behind you. We've seen more media personnel waiting for Rajnikanth behind you than long queues there in Chennai. But let's
know.
Yes, Veera,
I
want
know,
to
Rishika,
say something.
I think we'll also have nice idli vada after this. The other thing about waking up early morning and coming out to vote is that you can go and have your nice idli vada. This area has some fascinating hotels around here. So you can come down, vote and have your nice idli vada,
so
dosa, pongal, whatever you want after you cast your vote.
More incentive to come out and vote there. But let's quickly shift gears and also go across to the other big politically significant state of Maharashtra, which has seen so much up and down, so much political upheaval. Ronak is joining us live at the moment from Nagpur. Ronak, of course, Nagpur is the bastion for Nitin Gadkari. He's seeking a third term from there. But a lot at stake this time in the state of Maharashtra, and it almost feels like the people, the voter, has just been forgotten in all the politics. What are the issues that dominate? You know, all that we've talked about as far as Maharashtra is concerned in this election is the political turmoil that Maharashtra is seeing with parties that have splintered across from the last election. It's almost forgotten what's on the mind of the voter. How is the voter feeling about this whole issue? You may vote for a certain party. They may cross over and become another party or break away from their own family. It's been very, very interesting, you know, the battle for Maharashtra.
जी देखिए, निश्चित तौर पर बिल्कुल आपने सही सवाल किया है। दरअसल जो मतदाता है उनके मन में भी ये सवाल, जब हमने सुबह जब मतदान केंद्रों पर पहुंचे तब भी इस तरह की जो सवाल है हमने लोगों से पूछे थे, तो निश्चित तौर पर लोग कन्फ्यूज है। और लोगों का कहना है कि अगर वोट हम कुछ सोच समझ कर दे रहे हैं तो उसका गलत इस्तेमाल जो है वो नेताओं ने नहीं करना चाहिए। इस वक्त मैं आपको तस्वीरें दिखा दूँ, मैं इस वक्त नागपुर के मतदान केंद्र में हूँ। यहाँ पर थोड़ी देर बाद केंद्रीय मंत्री नितिन गडकरी भी मतदान करने के लिए पहुंचेंगे, और आप तस्वीरें देख सकते हैं कि सुबह से ही लोग यहां पर जो है क्यू में लगे हुए हैं। और मुख्य तौर पर आप यहां देख सकते हैं कि सुबह से ही लोग यहां पर मतदान केंद्र पर पहुंचे हुए हैं। लेकिन जो सवाल आपने किया कि कुछ लोग भी हमारे साथ हैं, उनसे जानने की कोशिश करेंगे कि क्या कुछ वो सोचते हैं। ये बताइए कि क्या नाम है आपका, मतदान किया है आपने?
मैं श्री वल्लभ गोखले।
अच्छा, ये बताइएगा कि मुख्य तौर पर आप लोगों को क्या लगता है जब आप मतदान करने के लिए यहाँ पर पहुँचते हैं और मतदान तो कर देते हैं लेकिन नेता दूसरी तरफ चले जाते हैं?
नहीं, ऐसा कुछ नहीं है। हमने आज तक जो कुछ मतदान किया हुआ है उसके रिजल्ट हमको शहर में दिखाई दे रहे हैं। जो पूरा डेवलपमेंट शहर हो रहा है, जो अंतर्राष्ट्रीय स्तर पर अंतर्राष्ट्रीय स्तर पर जिस तरह नागपुर का नाम रोशन हुआ है, तो ये सब डेवलपमेंट देख कर हमने मतदान किया हुआ है।
आप यहाँ पर देख सकते हैं कि कुछ इस तरह की प्रतिक्रिया यहाँ पर देखने को मिल रही है। और मुख्य तौर पर लोगों का साफ तौर पर यहाँ पर नागपुर में अगर देखें तो सुबह से ही मतदान केंद्रों पर भीड़ जो है वो लोगों की देखने को मिल रही है। और लोगों का कहना है कि विकास एक बड़ा मुद्दा है जिसको ध्यान में रखते हुए वो इस बार मतदान करने के लिए मतदान केंद्रों पर पहुंचे हैं। जी,
वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग रौनक, जो आप कह रहे हैं इट्स इंटरेस्टिंग बिकॉज यू नो इट इज गोइंग टू बी ऑन द माइंड ऑफ द वोटर इजंट इट दिस टर्न कोड पॉलिटिक्स एंड इट्स महाराष्ट्र इज ऑफ कोर्स पिक्यूलियर वीरा व्हेन इट कम्स टू टर्न कोड पॉलिटिक्स बट महाराष्ट्र इज नॉट द ओनली स्टेट. So is this something that the voter is going to think about? Is this something that in a certain sense, you know, propels that voter apathy that you and I were talking about just a short while ago, where people lose faith in the process?
There are two kinds there, right, Rishika? There are those politicians who are able to take their votes and they're called the transferable votes, the one who can take their votes and shift sides with ease and you know, carry that along because they've got their appeal, which is either caste-based or something sectarian, something that identifies with the people. And then there are those who have a vote base which cannot be transferred. For instance, they jump from one party to another. It's, you know, it doesn't work. For instance, in Tamil Nadu, you have this fascinating loyalty to the symbol, which is the two leaves and the rising sun symbol, which is what the BJP wants to break through and try and emerge as a third player. The projection of a local leader here, Annamalai as well, who I expect will be voting somewhere in Coimbatore shortly, you know, where he's going to be. Several big faces going to vote in a bit, right, Rishika? You've got several ex-AIADMK leaders like TTV Dinakaran, who's contesting in the Theni Lok Sabha constituency. You've got the former Chief Minister O Paneer Selvam contesting from the Ramnad of Lok Sabha constituency. Will they be able to take their old AIADMK vote along? They are contesting as part of the BJP alliance. So these are fascinating questions. Of course, in Chennai South, you've got a fascinating contest. You've got Tamilisai Soundarajan of the BJP, former governor of Telangana, who's contesting here. You've got Jayavardhan, who's the son of a very strong AIADMK leader, you know, D. Jayakumar's son. He's a one-time MP as well. And then you have Tamirachi Thangapandian of the BJP, who's of the DMK, who's contesting here. So you've got fascinating contests that are playing out in different parts of the state. And to answer that question, it may not be as relevant in urban areas, but
yes.
As far as Chennai is concerned, for instance, party loyalties are considered very high as well in the city. It's been seen as a DMK bastion. Most of these seats the DMK has held all along, except in the 2014 rout election that the DMK faced after 2G. They've held most of these seats for 6-7 terms consistently.
Well, absolutely. And I think the other big question here, the other big story here, of course, is going to be, you know, what really happens to the BJP. Can they up their vote share? Can they pick up a seat or two? It's been a very high-octane campaign as far as the BJP is concerned in Tamil Nadu. We'll talk a little more about that. But we have Vedant back with us. We also have Amritanshi joining us from Chindwara. I want to go to Amritanshi at the moment.
Yeah.
Amritanshi, Madhya Pradesh is is going to be very, very interesting to see what happens after the rout that the Congress has faced there. You are in Chindwara, which is literally the lone bastion that the Congress has been able to hang on to as far as the last election is concerned. But this time, the battle for Chindwara has also been very, very interesting with a mass exodus from the Congress that has happened. And it's an interesting exodus because
surely very interesting battle in Chindwara. And right now we are present at the Congress, Chindwara booth with his family votes here. Also, as you can see, there are people present here in the morning itself. And we have a voter with her with us. Like, she's the first time voter here. And we'll try to talk to her that on which things they are voting. You're the first time voter here. And how much excited you are after voting? And does this feel different, like you are contributing to the country?
It feels very different to actually be able to vote. We youth have been actually very opinionated people. We've been having opinions for a very long time. We have heard a lot of things. We have heard people say a lot of things. People make a lot of promises. A lot of opinions of ours were formed through social media especially. But it feels very good to actually make a difference and actually be able to vote and put that opinion into reality.
What are the things like you have been voting, or what does the youth of this country wants?
The youth really does want a change. And it's been a very long time. Change is very impending. And we really, really want this country to not lead to an impending doom and actually be able to form a change on the ground reality through things like changing unemployment, women's safety, and actually show us development on the ground level.
So basically, these are the first time voters, they have been saying that unemployment is the biggest issue. And also, as you've been seeing, like, this is the Chindwara booth, all the law and order is maintained here. And people were there forming lines since morning for voting. As the voting started at 7 a.m. and also all the ID cards have been checked, no mobile phones are allowed inside. And here also a list has been put down by the Election Commission for information related to all the candidates. Around 15 candidates are representing from different parties in these Lok Sabha elections. The main fight is between Nakul Nath, who has been from Congress, and Vivek Banti Sahu, who is from BJP. And also kind of very excitement in the voters in Chindwara since morning.
Well, a lot of excitement among voters in Chindwara, but what's also going to be very interesting to see in this first phase, Amritanshi, is which way the tribal vote goes. Because I think of the 6 of the 29 seats that are seeing polling in Madhya Pradesh today, they're all predominantly tribal seats. The tribal vote, of course, all important as far as Madhya Pradesh is concerned, traditionally with the Congress. But who knows? Because it's going to be very interesting to see how this battle plays out. That vote base had shifted towards the BJP, making significant gains in the tribal vote base in the last election. Can they capitalize on that once again? All those are big questions. We're going to have to slip into a very short break. But on the other side, we'll go back to Vedant, who's joining us from Alwar, where the mercury and the political temperatures this time are both going to be very high. A lot at stake.